Mina-san, konnichiwa, this is David.
I'm Mina.
And tonight we are doing our first review in quite some time. We're reviewing the RG00 Quanta.
And he's real.
And it is totally real.
And graded.
Yes, real and graded. They would have it in Build Fighters. RG system, I think. This is the RG00 Quanta. It's pretty.
Yeah.
I love it. I have some problems with it, but by and large, it's an amazing kit. It's kind of marvelous, actually. Like, let's see if we can get a good focus there. I didn't add all of the normal RG stickers. I've got the foil stickers on there. I might eventually add the rest of the RG stickers. Mm-hmm. If you've seen them, they're nothing different than you would expect right now, which should be pretty high. They're very similar to the ones in the 00 and the Exia. They are very, very great accent pieces. They're all like rub-on decal style stickers. And the foil stickers are all but necessary, in my opinion. They really, really sell the kit. Because they help to round out those GN condensers. Like, I don't know if my iPad is gonna get the imagery there. You can actually almost see it. You can see the call sign, the 00Q, along the side, on the top right of that. These are really, really high detailed kits. Let's see if we can get the jewel on his chest here. Yeah.
Yeah, move them around a little bit.
Oh, yeah, there we go. There we go. You can see the 00 Quanta designator there. Mm. Yeah, so this is beautiful. Now, this is also probably its biggest drawback. So we had one big frustration when I was building it, and that frustration is right here, that jewel on the head. It holds the V-fin on. It also holds on that blue piece right there, and it holds it on with, like, raw tension. So if you knock it in the wrong way, it will fire off. And that's what it did for us, is it literally shot across the room, and it's so tiny that it's very, very hard to find. I was not able to. Mina was able to.
By sheer luck.
Yeah. And I was really disappointed, because had I lost that, it would have really screwed up the kit. That's not a piece that I can just replace on my own. Like, I can't just cut down a piece of green plastic and put it in there, because it's so small. And it serves such an essential role from a physics standpoint, keeping it in there.
Yeah, I almost wish we had ruler up to show you just how ridiculously small that is.
Yeah, it's wee tiny. But you
could step on it and not feel it. That's how small it is.
Yeah, it was really, really small. But by and large, this is a really great kit. It has the normal level of articulation that you should expect from RG kits. I mean, and you know, pieces will pop off. They're not the most stable kits. They're not as stable as even HGs, because, you know, they have a lot to do. They have plenty of articulation. It's maybe not the greatest, because the 00 line does have quite a few of these little things to stop the arms from moving and the legs from moving. So it's not perfect. The armor plating. Like here, we have this extra piece of armor plating that's going to stop the leg from a full range
back
of motion.
The knee armor.
But you can actually move it out of the way and you get quite a bit of range. Now, like, if you really need him to articulate more than that, I have no idea how you're trying to pose him, but like, it's not like the red frame Astray in pure articulation quality. The skirts are solid. I actually like the way that the skirts are put on. They're not the way that most kits are. There's like a slide mechanism in there that keeps them held in so they don't pop off. Skirts popping off is a huge problem with a lot of kits, not this one.
See how I'm not making a joke?
Yeah.
See?
Now, another thing that you'll notice is that it does not use all of the RG parts. When you build it, you will quickly realize that the RG arms are not used in this kit. The RG frame and the arms is not used.
What you were worried about is you were fresh putting it together.
I was a little worried about it because I was like, why am I taking these pieces off? But so you actually take the RG arms off and put the take the hands off and use the RG hands. But the arms themselves, not used at all. It actually has its own unique arm mechanism, and that's actually a practical choice, partly because it helps it to hold its weaponry, which is kind of absurd. Also, it is asymmetrical. The 00 Quanta is asymmetrical, which is a fun little thing to build. It's subtly asymmetrical.
But it means you've got to follow the instructions or you're going to put shit on backwards.
Yeah, and what she's saying is that I did put a couple things on backwards because of the asymmetry.
I wasn't going to out you.
Yeah, so, you know, be mindful of that.
But he's over there working and I keep hearing, shit, not symmetrical, shit.
Yeah, and with an RG, a lot of the pieces on an RG will snap into place and they're almost impossible to get off. So if you build them asymmetrical, or if you build them incorrectly on an asymmetrical build like that, then you're going to have problems.
Okay, so important lesson, Japanese lesson here. What is the Japanese sound word for when a Gundam part clicks in?
Bachin.
Okay, so, and we've actually heard our kids say bachin, bachin, but we didn't know what it meant. It's the sound of metal or something clicking into place.
Yeah, so bachin is, they actually use the designator in the instructions. I never really paid attention to it before, but I'll just show you here. Mm-hmm. There we go, right there, the katakana bachin.
Bachin, bachin.
Yeah, that's bachin. That is to tell you that the piece snaps into the other piece and you should basically keep pushing it in until you hear a pop. But
and I think that's the same sound they use for like a seatbelt.
Yes, actually, yeah. It is. So that's an important Japanese lesson if you're interested in completely nonsensical stuff. So anyway, as I said, it's a little bit asymmetrical, so that makes it a little bit challenging. There's a lot of tiny pieces. I would actually recommend trying to do it with some tweezers.
Magnifying glass, if you got it.
Yeah, a magnifying glass is actually valuable. And I this is so weird. I've never really felt that way with Gunpla before. Mm. But there are a lot of pieces, like the foil stickers, where you really want to pay attention to the way that they're angled. And you actually have to look at them very closely to see where the words are. Mm. So if you want them to be accurate, then you're probably going to have to use a magnifier. So,
like the setups that the guys who go fly fishing do, right?
Yeah, Yeah, like, it's not necessary, but I think that it's actually a kind of important choice to make here. Mm. Okay, and so the accessories, we're going to take a look at those real quick. They're actually really well affixed, which is nice.
So he's got most of it built, and all of a sudden he goes, what are they going to do? Are they going to make me, like, make a fingernail-sized GN drive? Oh, I think we're skipping that. That's weird. And then all of a sudden I hear him go, oh, damn it.
Yeah. So it actually has a GN drive, yep. Which is kind of cool.
Also shiny.
And there we go. And it pops out. Actually, I didn't pop it out correctly. But anyway, it pops out. And it has a little locking mechanism, so you can pop out the GN drive. Which is weird. I don't know, but it's totally there, which is kind of cool. I would not hold it against them if they did not make it that way, if they just made it affixed. So here's your shield. The shield piece is nice and modular. There's the engine piece, the thruster of sorts, and it pops down there. So whenever it's on the back, the thruster is outward. Mm. And, you know, that's actually really nice and comfortable. Then it has all of these bits, these sword bits. And they actually fix in various ways to the shield.
They fly off the shield as
well. Yeah, they fly off too. I mean, that's technically what they do, so it makes sense.
Okay.
Okay, and so you take those off, pop these off. Now, all of the fixtures that hold those bits are actually like collapsible, so like they go into the kit itself, like into the shield, and you can hide them.
So you have the powered down shield.
Yeah, like it just looks regular, and it hides all of the fixtures. Mm. So just, you know, it's cleaner. And then these sword bits come apart, as you might expect. So there's six of those. And they're all independently usable as weapons, because, you know, Setsuna has to have a million bladed weapons for whatever reason. Yeah. Well, and that's it, too, because there's the GN sword, and then there's all of those bits. Mm. So he does actually have seven swords. If you don't know, Setsuna's name is a pun.
Yep.
Basically, his name means seven swords.
Mm-hmm.
And let's see if I can remember how to do this without looking it up. I probably can't.
You put that thing there. No.
They're actually kind of hard.
Mm.
Yeah. I actually had a lot of problems with it the first time because it's a little difficult to get them to snap into place, and they're not exactly the most stable once they get there. I am fairly certain it's these ones.
There's somebody watching this video right now going, oh my god, it goes on this way.
Yeah, that's it.
Screaming at the screen.
Okay, so it pops on like that, then you got your second one that pops on like that. These are actually pretty stable. Not all of them are.
No bachin.
No, there was no bachin. I guess maybe a little bachin. I don't know. And so then I believe, or maybe these are the bottom ones.
Seriously, there's somebody screaming at their screen.
I know. I'm basically just doing this to piss them off.
Sorry.
I can't remember how those go.
They go into a fleshy robot pilot. That's what
they do. I don't know. Give me a second here. I'm going to take a look at the pictures. Yes. I've only done it once. Okay.
Meanwhile, we've got an upskirt shot of the poor Gundam.
Yeah, right? Okay. Oh, see, these are upside down. That's the problem. I put them on upside down.
Oh, see, you know, you've got to pay attention.
Okay. So... they actually, what you do is you put these on, and then you put them into here.
Oh.
And they don't really affix very well. Mm. It's not great.
It's polite suggestion rather than...
Yeah, it's... yeah, like they're a little stable, not very stable.
So you don't want to put this together in sword fight.
No. And in fact, if you expect to pose it, also expect to put it back together a few times and fuss with it a little bit.
Possibly glue it.
Yeah, because it's not the most stable. But, you know, it's an RG, so it's really tiny. And it's kind of a mystery how they even did it in the first place, you know? And then that snaps onto there. There was a little bachin.
Yeah.
A little one there.
This is a ridiculous weapon.
It really is.
Like, are we full on into magical robot?
Now? Yeah, this is a super robot.
Super robot. I'll never get those terms right.
It's okay. Yeah, it doesn't matter. Anybody who cares about it doesn't really have a life.
Mm. Ooh.
Okay.
Sorry, fan who cares about it.
Okay, there we go. And that's the weapon itself. Yeah, isn't it pretty? And then you can actually break this part off a little bit and hope that that part doesn't unsnap. And then basically it becomes like a pincher weapon.
Which, of course, you could totally practically use in space battle. That looks like something that's very functional.
Yeah, it's very Setsuna is what it is. It's a perfect weapon for him. So that's what it looks like. And then you can re-snap it in, and you know, you have to actually use the unique hand for it,
because
it's big. And it pops right in, and of course it is way too big to actually hold. And then, you know, pieces sometimes fall off, because, you know, why not? Okay, and so this, of course, has its own stand.
Basically have to leave the room to get far enough back to get the whole damn thing in the shot.
Yeah. I can pull them back a little if you need. Stand's actually pretty strong.
I'll just go next door and record for you.
Yeah. There we go. the weapon is big. Like, it's pretty monstrous. It's not, like, necessarily, like, the tactical arms on a red frame, but it's huge, and it's unwieldy, and it's very impractical.
But it casts a pretty shadow.
It does. The nice green silhouette there is great. I would not leave it posed like that, just because, like, any little thing is going to knock it over, and then you're going to have sword bits all over. So, I would not recommend you do that. I'm gonna pop these off real quick. Oh.
Meanwhile, the Gundam's lying there saying, "You're not my father." Oh, sorry. Can't make Star Wars references when playing with Gundams.
Yeah, that's
David foams at the mouth and starts twitching.
I do.
But you've seen a Star Wars movie now, so.
I have seen a Star Wars movie now. That was some interesting. Yeah. It was it was okay.
There was certainly a lot of ooh and
yeah. So anyway, there's that, and it comes apart pretty easily. I mean, coming apart is actually the problem it has, not the solution. So it actually goes right back together pretty well, and the shield fits on the back pretty well as well. I actually had it posed at the beginning of the episode, but he can't really stand up with it. For obvious reasons, it's this big, huge thing on his back.
And he's a space robot.
Yeah, he's not really made for ground combat.
There's a bit about that in one of the series, too, right? Like, they have to land on Earth, and he's all, like, gravity sucks.
Yeah, I think that's actually 00, or is it Seed? I can't remember.
Whatever, man. Maybe they all do that gag.
Yeah. But it fits on very well. And it
so
also...
So that GN drive is there... But most of the time is covered up by the backpack.
Yeah. The GN drive is pretty much covered up. Like, I mean, you can always take the shield and move it over here so it actually functions as a shield.
Right.
That's cute. Yeah. It's a nice little thing. And I like the way that it hides those pieces. And the backpack piece that holds the shield, it's actually very tense. It's very good at holding it into place. Which is admirable for an RG for a tiny kit like this. Yeah. So.
No, that looks like something out of the cartoon.
It does. It really does.
Shield bit.
Yeah. And yeah, so that's it. It doesn't really have any other accessories. It does come with the extra hands that you would expect.
Other than the huge friggin' sword.
It comes with quite a few RG pieces that are not used, which is interesting. Mm. And actually, I guess if you wanted to build RG arms on things, you could do that with a little modification. You could actually put those on an HG.
Yeah, give somebody an extra set of arms.
Yeah, or you could, extra set. Because I think, and you know, don't quote me on this because I haven't checked it out, but I think that those holes are standard peg sizes for HG kits, too. Mm. So if you had, like, some of the bonus backpack kits or something, I think you could turn those into a set of arms. That would be kind of cool.
Nice.
Yeah.
Armor or...
Yeah. But, that's, it only really comes with the two accessories, but the two accessories are like 10 accessories, so. There you go. I really like it. I love the 00 Quanta, but I think that it really does justice to it. I think that it improves upon, the older versions, and I think it's definitely a strong kit, just like I thought the 00 and the Exia were.
How much did it run here?
I think it was 2,100 yen, which is about $20.
So not bad at all.
Yeah. The yen is actually a little stronger right now than last year, when last time we started really doing these reviews. So that's a little different, but it was about $20, which is really a steal. I think it's a great kit for that amount. Particularly considering, the articulation and the detail of this thing, the equivalent action figure would be $60, $70. Mm. This is a really fun little build. Although, I would say it's also a little difficult to balance because he's asymmetrical. I would say it's pretty challenging. I don't often consider Gunpla to be challenging, but it has so many tiny parts, more than your average RG, and the ones that are tiny... are in many cases essential.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Easy stuff to screw up.
Don't lose that crown gem.
Yes, be very careful with the V-fin. but once it's in there, it's pretty good. You have to make for sure it's actually in there and not like most of the way in there. The butching. And I would even use a little bit of glue. Just drop a single drop. But if you put a little glue in there, it'll fuse and then it'll hold the other pieces in really well. And you know, you'll want tweezers because of the stickers. The stickers are so small. And I would recommend magnifying glass for them. Just if you want to put them on right. It doesn't really matter. If it's so small that you need a magnifying glass, like you can't really read it to begin with. But if you want it to look correct, then that's probably the way you'd want to go. I would really recommend it. If you're even remotely interested in the 00, the 00 Quanta, it's a cool kit. It's really fun. I like it. And yeah, if you haven't already, like, subscribe, comment, all that jazz. If there's anything you want to see, let us know. We'll try to get to it. I'm going to try to get a couple more of these up soon. Yeah, until then, matane, everyone.
Matane.